lot like an airplane pilot. You sit here and you monitor things, make sure everything's working properly.
Okay, did you notice Mike's hands are not on the steering wheel of the combine while he's harvesting? The trend started several years ago, global positioning systems taking over harvest.
So tonight, our Eric Hansen headed out to the field to see how the now popular technology is working.
Glance at any field in Iowa and you'll see a lot has changed color in the last few weeks. But look closer inside those cabs and you'll find even more has changed for farmers the last few years.
Stop a busy farmer long enough to talk and you'll spot a smile on their face this fall.
The bean yields are probably some of the best bean yields I've had ever.
Mike Brelsford's first week in the field's been good. Want proof?
The big green circle there on the screen is where we're at in the field.
Go to the satellite.
It's showing your yield as you go in the field.
And green is great. GPS tracks it live. But the yellow bulb over the John Deere's cab is also synced with satellites to drive Mike's massive combine. He's been hands-free for 6 years. He doesn't nap, though.
Making sure the cut is where we want it. And then you have time to work with your cell phone and do some of that stuff, too. So answer emails and things like that.
Steering only when he turns around. And when he's full and that tractor pulls up,
he's on autopilot too, so.
It's a hands-free operation.
It's amazing. You think about the combine steering itself, but it can't be really that big of a deal. But at the end of a 10-hour day, it's amazing how much more refreshed you are by not having to actually sit there and keep the edge of that sickle within 5 or 6 inches of the row.
So they don't hit each other or waste fuel. In the next few months, wagons will respond to a combine speed too. Some prototypes don't even need people in the tractors at all. It's not your grandpa's farm equipment.
It's pretty easy until you have to write the check. Then it gets hard.
But they say it's worth the thousands extra it costs.
And just like the rest of America, it keeps on changing. In Dallas County, Eric Hansen, News Channel 8, Iowa's News Leader.